Well, folks, it is, I think it's going to be the last day here in Missouri. Perrick and I are here. This is the warehouse where we keep all the favorite rods. And Perrick and I are waiting for a new shipment of rods to come in. Rods and reels, stuff that we helped kind of design, figure out what you guys would like. But today's going to be different. We are going trout fishing for part of the day and then pond bass fishing. So if you don't like the trout thing, you can skip to the bass part. But the rod I'm using today, I'm going to test it out. It's kind of a newer rod. It's a finesse rod. It's made for trout, panfish. You can catch some bass on it. You can do pretty much whatever you want with it. It's going to be that balance. You guys always see me with that orange rod and reel. But since I'm using that one, I talked to Winston, the owner favorite that I'm here with, and I talked to him. I said, hey, can we get a deal for the people at home? If you guys are looking for a finesse rod, can we hook them up? So he said yes. We are going to give you a $130 spinning combo for $100. So you get $30 off you'll see it later on. I'm going to be using it. It's going to be the spinning combo that I'm using to catch trout. That is the combo. So if you guys want a finesse rod, you guys click the links down below, get $30 off, $100 for a $130 combo. Pretty sweet deal, but I gotta go find Perrick. Gotta get everything spooled up, ready to go. Go catch some trout.
You excited?
Excited as I'll ever be. That sounded really excited. I'm actually pretty excited. Look at this. A little river. I haven't done this in a while. This is gonna be part two, Catch and Cook, brought to you by Andrew Flair.
You don't have any line, you don't have any lures. Kid literally has nothing. He has a rod with nothing. But we're here in, I think we're in Arkansas, actually. We're not even in Missouri. And we are going trout fishing. Maybe some walleye, I think is what I heard. We're doing a Catch and Cook part two featuring AP Bassin. We are, we're actually with the owner, CEO of Favorite Rods. We've been chilling at his house for a few days. We're testing out some new gear here. Pretty excited for this. Should be fun.
10-pound orange. Favorite. Can they buy this?
Yeah.
You guys can buy this. You guys can buy this on the
this
site.
This is orange and this is
orange and we got green. 10-pound line.
I don't know the last time I fished with 10-pound line.
It's like hair. Yeah. Kind of like hair.
Yeah. Basically, we're hair fishing today.
We're gonna spool these up real quick and. See that little river going down there? We're gonna catch some trout.
All right, let's see if we can. How do you work this thing, Mister?
But we are gonna sell this rod for $90.
Right, we're off. I'm gonna grab my big camera here. Perrick and Winston. So like I said, Winston's the owner favorite. They're down here fishing. I don't know if we're gonna do a challenge. I know Perrick and Winston want to do a challenge. I might let them kind of do their own challenge, and then me. Come up with something. We'll just kind of see. I'm just kind of excited to try to catch some fish. I've never really fished this way. I've never even fished in like a river or creek or whatever the hell this is. I've never really fished like this. So I'm gonna give this the old college try here and see if I can make some magic happen. First cast here. That worked. Ooh, that was a bite. Ooh, we dropped it. Oh, I think I had a bite. Yeah, I had a bite on that one for sure. Just a little guy. Well, casting these is pretty difficult. There's only one way you could really fish this way, and that's kind of the setup I've got is, you know, 10-pound test, maybe even 8-pound test. Oh, braided line, just super, super light braid. And I'm using a 6'6" light rod and a balance reel to match. So we're kind of testing these out. We just got these in, and we're gonna see if I like these little guys. All right, so I switched to a little Meps here. Oh, Perrick. I got one. Yeah, I do. Yeah, oh God, it's a giant. It's a giant. Dude. Oh. I got you all excited. Look at that little flare fish. Did you get worried for a second? We're eating good tonight, boys. Ready to cook this guy up? All right, majestic release here. See, buddy? He's good to go. Oh yeah. We on the board with bass. Can't really eat that. I mean, you can, but we're not going to. Uh-oh, Winston. Does Winston have a big one? Oh God, what do we got here? Oh, we got a nice rainbow. There you go. That's an eater size for sure.
Filet.
Filet?
Still. Yeah.
Yeah, I think I might need to go to the Meps. Well, I guess we're not eating that one.
Nice job, buddy.
All right. We're starving tonight, boys.
There's one. Oh, I got one. I got one. Oh yeah, right off the rock. I got snagged. Oh gosh, what is that? Is that a bass? I think I got a good bass. Oh yeah. Bass, yeah. Come here, little bugger. Look at Eve, you choked it. Well, I came here to catch some trout and stuck to my roots with the old largemouth bass, eh? See you later, Freddy. There goes Freddy. He munched this little thing. I thought it was a big one. You know, this light rod and light line and everything, you could really feel the fish. It's actually kind of cool. I don't really fish like this very often. I'm usually using, you know, 7 foot, 7'3" heavies and medium heavies and braid and 18 pound fluorocarbon and all that stuff. This is kind of fun using the finesse setup for a change. You having fun? Take a little snack break.
Break the snake. Oh God, it's shaking. Oh God.
Give us the plan. What's the plan, Perrick?
We gotta go do something.
This ain't working?
Well, you haven't even caught a trout.
I know, I haven't. You having fun?
Come on, Perrick, let's go!
I've been waiting for you guys for 10 minutes.
Get Hold jacket, scooter back.
Come on, last
one. We are,
This is super fun.
We're pond fishing now. Oh man, Perrick's having too much fun with these kid toys.
Got a few rods in the back of the truck here.
I'm gonna organize all that tomorrow. I might make a video. Maybe not.
Be back in a little bit.
Let's do this. All right, folks. We are back doing the old Fisherman Flair thing here. I'm gonna start with, you guys guessed it, the old chatterbait. It's windy, super windy. So hopefully audio's not too garbage here, but I'm just gonna go and try to catch some bass. I mean, I had a lot of fun catching them trout. Ha! Kidding, I didn't catch any trout. Attempted to catch trout. I mean, it was pretty fun, not gonna lie. It's kind of a nice change of pace, you know, fishing a river. But gotta bring me back to my roots to close out the day in the vidja, as Outlaw would call it. And see if we can catch some big ol' slaunch largemouth on the chatterbait. There's one. I got a big one. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, come on.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
No! That was like a six! Did you see that? I just... Dude, what the heck? I lost him like 6 feet out and he just swam to the bank. Oh my God. What the hell just happened? I'm soaking wet. I almost caught that with my hands. I grabbed onto its side. How? How did that happen? I don't know how I didn't keep him pinned. I have no idea how I didn't just catch that fish. All right, well, that's how you, I don't even know how I lost that fish, to be honest. I had him pinned for quite a while, but I ran into the water after him, which normally, you know, that's not something I normally do, but that fish swam right to the bank. I don't think I've ever seen that. I don't know how well you guys can see on the GoPro if the GoPro is tilted down enough, but wow, my mind's blown right now. I don't know what to tell you guys. I did my best. I got soaking wet and I'm covered in mud now. Trying to catch that fish with my bare hands. It didn't really work out. There's one. Keep him pinned. Yep, keep him pinned. It's not very big. It's not as big. I'm water skiing him. That's more of a flare fish. That's more of what I'm used to catching. That last one was much bigger. Just a little pipsqueak. Feels pretty good though. I think we're starting to kind of get him dialed in a little bit more. Actually catching some fish. The rod that I'm throwing here, you guys always see me with this rod when I'm throwing chatterbait. This is by far my favorite chatterbait rod. And it's really good for spinnerbait swim jigs. I also use it for square bills and lipless cranks. It's like a good moving rod bait. So if you're just kind of throwing some moving baits, this rod is
This rod is pretty sick. Like I said, I'll drop the links down below if you guys want this rod or the rod that I was trout fishing with. Let's see if I can keep this one pinned this time. Keep it pinned, baby. I think this one's bigger. Maybe. No, not quite. Not quite the big one that I lost, but oh my God, look how fat this thing is. Let's talk about how this is my favorite chatterbait rod. That's why, right there. Although I did lose that fish earlier, it was my fault, it wasn't the rod's fault. Look at that fish. Grand old time pond fishing. Get that little salad off you, buddy. See you later, Christian. Whoa, Christian, chill out, dog. There you go. Oh, that's it, that's her, dude. Peric just caught her.
That's a good one.
Peric just caught that fish. I guess I shouldn't say that's her, there could be more, but that's a good one.
Well, that was crazy.
Well, that wasn't as big as I thought.
No, that fish though.
That's a good one though. I thought that was the big one. Let's see that one.
I'm kicking Flair's butt right now for size.
I just missed one, all right? If I had the one, you would have been toast, all right? I've caught a few. That's a good one, yeah. That's probably four.
Yeah, 4 pounder.
Good one, dude. So you guys know me whenever I'm doing fishing videos in general. I do my best to give tips. You know, you guys have probably seen me throwing chatterbait a bajillion times, and I've probably given out quite a few tips. So there's not too much that I can give out that you guys probably haven't already seen. But this one is just, it's more of like a winter tactic. You know, you see me throw this in the spring, the summer, and the fall. I don't throw this much in the winter, and it's, you know, it's February in Missouri, and it's getting down to like the 20, 25, 30 at night. And so kind of how I'm retrieving is you usually want to go with like a slower gear ratio, maybe like a 6.4 or 5.4 or something like that. And then you want to keep your rod tip up high, and you kind of just want to feather it. Just kind of like lift your rod and kind of reel. And you just kind of like almost like a start and stop, just kind of pause. And it kind of like you would like a lipless crankbait ripping out of grass. That's kind of how I'm working it today. And same thing with Peric. Peric's throwing a spinnerbait and a lipless, doing the same thing, just kind of fluttering it. Working it slow, but not like a jig slow. You know, you at least keep it a moving bait, but just kind of feather it a little bit. Give it a little finesse action, and they seem to be munching it. There's one. That's a big one. Don't come off. Yeah, baby. What's up, Peric? Oh, snap.
Buddy, it's only about the same size I just
that's at least bigger. Yeah, it's a little bit bigger than yours. Look at that little bladed jig down in that mouth. Heck yeah, son. Getting release on this fish. Peric just caught another one, saying goodbye to Samantha here. See you later, Samantha. Well, we're doing big things here in Missouri, catching some slounches.
20 minutes later.
All right, I made it to another pond. Another fire pond. I don't know if this can be the last one or not, but we're gonna see if we can catch some more fish. We're just kind of exploring these ponds on the favorite rod's farm. Yep, there's one. First cast, baby. Not a giant, but I'll take it. A little squeak, squeak, McGee. That's how you figure out if there's any fish in ponds. I get that question commented all the time. Hey, Flair, how do you know which ponds have fish or not? Exactly like that. Take a search bait, like a chatterbait, spinnerbait, something like that, and chuck it around a little bit. Usually, if there's any fish, any active fish, they'll munch this little guy. Oh! Is he still there? He's still there. He's coming right at me. Oh, this might be a big one. No, that's a good one. Not a big one, but it's a good one. It's a little better than that last one. He ate it and came right at me. Yeah, he's about the same size. I thought he was bigger than that. Man, these things, I don't know. I feel like I just haven't caught fish in such a long time. These little pipsqueak McGee's, they feel like really big fish, but this rod is just phenomenal. I'm in love with it. I am in love with it. Yep, that's why, right there, another one. That's 2 for 2. There we go. That's actually, I think that might be, let's see how big, is this any bigger? He might be bigger. Yeah, that's a bigger one. That's a good one. Come here, little guy. Little 2 pounder. Right there. Chunk, look how chunky these fish are. You guys are seeing how shallow I'm fishing. I have to kind of throw these fish far to get them. But they're moved up on these banks. Really warm day today. And they're back here in this little cut feeding. Nice and shallow. There's one, that's a bigger one. That's 3 for 3. Yep, there's another one. That dude crushed it. He came completely out of the water for it. There we go, here's another one. I'm telling you guys, magic bait. Right there, little pond slayer. That is 3-4-3. Chunky little bass. See you, buddy. See if I can catch another fish here. So they're shallow, they're feeding, they're super active. Oh, he came off. Oh, that was 5-for-5. Oh, he ate my trailer. Son of a gun. Let's see, final pond. It's getting dark. You guys probably can tell it's getting dark. I'm gonna see if I can catch us a toad. There he is. There's one. That's a big one. Yep. Oh God. Oh God. It's huge. Yeah. Oh my gosh. That's a tank. That's a freaking tank.
Right at dark.
Oh my gosh. Looky there.
One we needed.
I thought it was like a 10.
It's a big one.
It's like 6 probably.
Yeah.
It's a good fish.
Look at me. Look at me.
Bam, baby. Woo! Look how fast.
Screaming over here like hooked the 10 pound mother.
This is a Perrick 10 pounder though, for sure. All right, letting Judy go. Thank you very much for the fun fight. What do you think it is, Perrick? 6? There she goes. See you later, Judy. Well,
that was a good way to end the day.
Woo! That's how it's done, baby.
That's about it, folks. That's all she wrote.
A few moments later.
Well, folks, ending the video here. Unfortunately, we have some bad news. All the rods and reels that Perrick and I waited all day today for aren't going to be here for 2 more days, and we have to get back to Texas. So unfortunately, we're just going to have them shipped to our house. We were pretty excited to show you guys that when the big semi gets backed up and show you guys all the cool new products that we have coming, but it's just not going to happen today. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. It started off as a catch and cook, in which I didn't do. Perrick did, though. So if you want to see Perrick's video, you can go check out his channel. He did the actual catch and cook where he caught the trout and cooked them. I basically failed at trout fishing, but caught a bunch of big bass. So it's okay in my book to do something like that. Perrick's upstairs editing. I wanted to wrap this video up. Thank you guys so much for watching. Really do appreciate it. Like, so if you want that chatterbait rod that I was using, I'll drop it down below, as well as that spinning rod and reel. Special pricing on that one, $30 off. It's a $130 combo just for you guys for $100. Got Winston to give me that deal for you guys. So you guys check that link out down below if you guys want any of that stuff. Otherwise, Favors got plenty of other rods and fishing gear like that. If you guys want some, I'll leave all the information down below. Really appreciate you guys tuning in. Headed to Texas tomorrow. So that will be a fun 8-hour drive with Perrick Big Nose Bassin. And hopefully we can do a little bit of pond fishing or some kayak fishing, some boat fishing all week long. Pretty excited. Pretty dang excited to go back to Texas and live inside the MTB crib for just a few days, and then I'm headed to Florida. So lots and lots of stuff going on. Thank you guys so much for watching, and peace.
Will I get this picture done? What do we want to do with this thing?
Yeah.
This is it?
You want me to take it or what?